Dear ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Klagemauer TV, news and reviews from all over the world. This year in May, the fifth edition of the DSM came out on the market. That is the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, which is the basis of treatment for millions of people. If the pharmaceutical industry gets their way, there will shortly be billions in treatment. For it is public knowledge that this manual defines what a psychiatric disorder is and provides the definitions for the World Health Organization. 69% of the authors of the DSM hold commercial connections to the pharmaceutical industry. That is an increase of 20% compared to 2006, when the DSM-4 was put together. In most of the task groups which were set up for drafting the DSM-5, experts with financial ties to the pharmaceutical companies were the majority. In the team for affective disorders, they account for 67% of the members. In the team for psychotic disorders, they account for 83%. In the team for working on insomnia, they account for 100%. Every sixth of these experts works as a medical representative for drug producers or is a member on their advisory boards. There are no clear biological indications for the psychiatric disorders described in the DSM-5 that can be determined, for example, through blood analysis or brain scans. Diagnosing the patient lies in the hands of the doctors alone. It seems that this manual will become the basis of a gigantic business, which talks humanity into being sick and for their services fills its pockets full of profits. Of course, all this at the expense of the state and of the citizens paying health insurance. Thank you for being with us this time. Please join us again soon on this channel.